Hello all. In this video we are going to learn valuation rules under GST. In the previous videos we have been studying section 15 and subsection 1, 2, 3 where we have learned the transaction value calculation and some inclusions and exclusions with some numerical examples and case study. And in this video onwards we are going to learn about the valuation rules. And as you can see, there are two types of valuation rules. General valuation rules and some specific or special valuation rules have been given for some transactions. So what is the difference here? General valuation rule is applicable for almost all the transaction wherever it is applicable. Specific valuation rules are applicable only to those transactions which are given here. Like example, there is example of this valuation in case of lottery, betting, gambling and horse racing. Only for these kind of transactions rule 31 is applicable. And rule 32, there are some currency exchanges and LIC agent, air travel agent. This kind of valuation rules have been given. Rule 33 is in case of pure agent, and rule 34 is in case of currency exchange other than INR. If you are a multinational company and you are making some accounting entries wherein you are considering the currency exchange rates, then how do you consider for GST? That is given in the rule 34. And rule 35, if you are supplying such supplies which already includes these kind of GSTs and or GSTs, then rule 35 is applicable. These are specific rules given for only those specific transactions. But in this case, general valuation rules, this is applicable to everyone, right? Even for these all, these rules are also applicable, but it should satisfy the conditions. Now let us start with the general valuation rules, rule 27. Valuation where the consideration is not wholly in money. Wherever the consideration is not wholly in money, rule 27 is applicable. See, as we have seen, there has to be two conditions satisfied in order to consider that transaction into section 15(1). And those two conditions are: the price has to be sole consideration and the supply must be made to the unregistered dealer. And therefore, if consideration is not wholly in money, where price is not sole consideration, you are also considering some other thing, that is in kind mode or in barter case, barter system. In such cases, rule 27 is applicable. What is this rule 27? Let us read this all, because this is given in the act. Where the supply of goods or services is for a consideration not wholly in money, the value of supply shall be the open market value, OMV, of such supply. So what is this open market value? We will see. First we will read. If the open market value is not available under clause A, if open market value is not available here, then the sum total of consideration in money and any such further amount in money as is equivalent to the consideration not in money, if such amount is known at the time of supply. What do you mean by this? Cash plus kind. If the value of supply is not determinable under clause A and B above, be the value of supply of goods or services are both of like kind and quality. We'll see what this point says. If the value is not determinable under clause A, B or C above, be the sum total of consideration in the money and such other amount in money that is equivalent to consideration not in money as determined by the application of rule 30 or 31 in that order. So first we are going to consider OMV. Then if OMV, that is open market value, is not available, then cash plus kind, that is what we are going to take, money or money's worth is what we are going to take. If that is also not available, then value of like kind and quality we are going to take. वैल्यू ऑफ सप्लाई ऑफ सच गुड्स एंड सर्विसेज ऑफ लाइक काइंड एंड क्वालिटी, दैट इज वॉट वी आर गोइंग टू कंसिडर. इफ दैट इज ऑल्सो नॉट अवेलेबल देन रूल 30 और 31 इज अप्लीकेबल. एक्सप्लेनेशन इज गिवन हियर विद दिस ब्यूटिफुल डायग्राम. वेयर द न्यू फोन इज सप्लाइड फॉर रुपीज 20,000. सो न्यू फोन, द प्राइस ऑफ न्यू फोन इज 20,000 अलॉन्ग विद द एक्सचेंज ऑफ एन ओल्ड फोन. ओके, 20,000 दैट टू विद द एक्सचेंज ऑफ ओल्ड फोन. एंड इफ द प्राइस ऑफ न्यू फोन इज ऑन द प्राइस ऑफ न्यू फोन विदाउट एक्सचेंज इज 24,000, द OMV ऑफ द न्यू फोन इज 24,000. दिस इज वॉट वी आर गोइंग टू कंसिडर. होप यू हैव अंडरस्टूड. देर इज अ फोन ऑफ 24,000 विथ एक्सचेंज यू आर गोइंग टू गेट इट फॉर 20,000. सो वॉट इज द प्राइस ऑफ ओल्ड फोन? दैट इज 4,000, राइट? सो इन दिस केस, इन दिस केस 24,000 विल बी द OMV. देर इज अनदर एग्जाम्पल वेर अ लैपटॉप इज सप्लाइड फॉर 40,000. द सेम एग्जाम्पल इज गिवन हियर. Okay, but still I will read. There, where the laptop is supplied for 40,000 along with the barter of printer. So printer is being bartered over here, that is manufactured by the recipient, and the value of printer known at the time of supply is 4,000. Value of the printer is 4,000 and laptop supplied is 40,000, but this is not the price of the laptop, but the OMV of the laptop is not known. The value of supply of laptop will be 44,000 because 40,000 is the supply value, it is not the open market value of the laptop, and 4,000 is the printer value. Both are supplied in coordination with each other, and therefore value will be 44,000. Here is the pictorial example where old computer is for 40,000 and cash we are giving for 4,000 rupees, right? Cash plus kind. So total will be 44,000. This is the consideration according to rule 27. Hope you have understood this point. This is very easy and clear to understand. Okay, with this picture, please note, if any transaction involves fully in consideration other than cash barter, and then also OMV will be checked. See, there is one point. If there is any such transaction that involves fully in a consideration other than cash, it means fully you are taking the barter only and not cash is involved. It means old computer is for 40,000 and cash is not available over here. So what will be the consideration? 40,000, because cash is not given, right? OMV will be checked. In such cases, OMV will be checked. Goods or services can be exchanged or vice versa or in combination. See, whatever to consider this OMV, goods or services, wherever it is exchanged, it can be considered. So what this point says is that you can exchange goods or you can also exchange services, right? If you are a good architect and if your friend is a builder, building construction business, then you can work, you both can work in coordination with each other, and whatever you supply to him or whatever he supplies to you is the service and not the goods, and therefore that will be the value of consideration, whatever you are supplying. Hope you are understanding. So flow of decision making under rule 27, here it is given. First we are checking OMV. This is in order, okay? This is in sequential order. I repeat, this all is in the sequential order only, or I will use the different word, preferential order. Means if OMV is applicable, if OMV is available, we are not checking other things. If OMV is not available, then we are going to check this money plus kind. If this is also not available, then we are going to check the value of supply of like kind and quality. If this is also not available, then money plus monetary value as determined as per rule 30 or 31 is applicable. Right? Similarly, wherever the value of supply of like kind and quality is not available, मनी प्लस मॉनेटरी वैल्यू एज डिटरमाइंड एज पर रूल 30 और 31 विल बी एप्लीकेबल. व्हाट इज दिस रूल 30? रूल 30 इज कॉस्ट बेस्ड वैल्यूएशन. रूल 31 इज बेस्ट जजमेंट मेथड. विल सी व्हाट दिस टू आर. विल सी इट लेटर. लेट अस फर्स्ट अंडरस्टैंड दिस इलस्ट्रेशन. सो दिस इज द इलस्ट्रेशन. एन इलेक्ट्रिशियन गेट्स हिज होम रिनोवेटेड फ्रॉम अ बिल्डिंग कॉन्ट्रैक्टर. Total cost of renovation is 2 lakh rupees. However, contractor normally charges 2,30,000 for similar work to unrelated parties. Electrician requests the contractor to pay only 1,50,000 through check, and he would work for the contractor to make electrical fittings for the next two projects of him. Determine value of supply in both cases. So what has happened here is case 1. There are two cases: value of supply from building contractor to electrician. And then case 2 is from electrician to contractor. We'll see the value of supply in both of these cases. Open market value is known, right? See, contractor normally charges 2,30,000 for similar work to the unrelated parties. It means this will be the open market value, not 2 lakh rupees. Even if the 2 lakh rupee is the actual consideration which is received by the contractor, right? But still we are going to consider the open market value. So therefore, case 1, value of supply from building contractor to the electrician, here open market value is given. Consideration will be equal to open market value 2,30,000. Value of supply from electrician to contractor is given. OMV, see, money is given 1,50,000, which we have received, which we have got here in the question. So 1,50,000 is paid through check plus 80,000. Why 80,000? It is the monetary value of supply of service which electrician is supplying to the contractor for the next two projects, right? So 2,30,000 is the total value of supply minus 1,50,000. This will be 80,000. So consideration is this much, 2,30,000. Did you understand this point? Right. This is what is all about Rule 27. Rule 28, we will see it in the next video.